We're in for a treat. Check it out.
But what I can say is that Roy Jones Jr. has one up on Bernard Hopkins. That's a major incentive for me. I'm undefeated when it comes, other than one fighter, so I'm not undefeated when it comes to rematches. Roy Jones never liked giving rematches because he figured a guy knows his style and he figured out his style. His history's shown that. But I'm gonna prove why Roy Jones Jr. had y'all wait this long. I'm gonna prove to everybody why Roy Jones Jr. for 17 years, full play his way all the way up to now, the real deal. And know what? After the full play, you know what happens to him. He gets beep, beep, beep. That's what's gonna happen. April 3rd. Tune in.
Roy Jones Jr., why has it taken this long to make this reach?
It's taken this long, like I just told you, and before he get beep, 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 beeped up, not beep, 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 it took this long for Big Head to get enough confidence to think that I've slowed down enough so he can bring that Big Head back in front of me, and he hoping now he can dodge these bullets. Last time the head was too big, he couldn't get out the way. This time it's still just as big, so how he gonna get out the way? But he hoping that he can, so he gonna always tell you it was me. Come on, dude, I got one dude out of all three times. So what do I care about a rematch?
Now, Chicken Man thinks that my head is big, fine. So he should have an easy time knocking his big head off my shoulders.
Block.
Let's see. Let's see, because I want to show the world, and I don't, you know, I'm glad, you know, all the press is paying attention, because I don't know what the headlines are going to say when I knock him out. But I think that people should look at how I knocked him out. You understand? How I knocked him out is going to be devastating in Glenn Johnson. And look, trust me, that was a devastating. But it's going to be devastating because that's the way I want him to remember Bernard Hopkins for his natural remaining of his natural life. Anytime you look at boxing, you're going to see that Bernard took him to this point where he wanted never to be any part of boxing, not even come to boxing shows. I want him to not like boxing anymore after this. Boxing would not be even his conversation. He wouldn't even let his kids go to boxing matches no more. Nobody, everybody in the Roy Jones family would be banned from boxing when I get done. That's the type of ass whooping that I want to put on this man. Now, I know I'm running for president. I want everybody to think I do cuss a little bit. But let me tell you something. That's the type of beat that I'm going to get this guy, man. Because it's a lot of, yeah, it's some animosity, but it's also personal. And then, let me tell you, if you think it's just hype and promotion, wait till you see this. I pulled off a lot of things in my career, but this is personal. He's going to have to be a man tonight. Come April 3rd, he's going to have to be a damn man. He's going to have to fight. And if he don't fight, I'm going to run him out of that ring.
Headline will read, Jones destroys Blockhead once again. Secondly, like I told y'all, the man's so jealous and so envious of me that he don't even want to see my kids watching a fight. It brings back nightmares. I mean, wow. I keep telling y'all, this
certain
thing about
certain
that.
Certain things are rated.
Hold on, Bernard.
Certain things kids shouldn't watch.
Don't the rules say you gotta shut up? Oh, I thought. All right. So, like I said, he can't stand the sight of seeing a pigmentation of me in a boxing ring. That's how bad he don't want to see nothing look like me close to a ring. Because it reminds him of that 17-year nightmare he's been living with. And I can understand that. You know what I'm saying? That's his drive and motivation. And I totally can understand that. Out of respect, you gotta respect that. The good thing is that he got the galls finally to say, you know what? Now I think he weak. I want to get him back. I love that.
Bernard?
I think that in American history, I think that certain things kids shouldn't be shouldn't see. I don't think a kid should watch porno tapes. I don't think kids should smoke cigarettes. I don't think kids should do things that can corrupt their mind. I think that when they see this execution live on TV, HBO, right, pay-per-view, there won't be a replay of this execution. See, I'm not going to be able to kill him and bring him back and kill him again. So, for everybody to understand, why I mention that is because this fight would not be shown after pay-per-view is seen. It won't be shown like, you know, you wait and you try to say, okay, I'm not paying for it, I'm going to wait next week. Richard, is he around? Anybody around? Can you back me, Oscar? You can back me up on that? So, if you don't watch it come April 3rd, You don't know who's going to buy it later on down the line, the license fee to show it 10 years, 5 years, 6 years from now. So you better watch it April 3rd, because that's the official signing of the government to get rid of this guy. His execution day is coming, and he will have a last meal because he requested that. I don't know if he like deer meat or steak or whatever he wants, he can have
it. It'll probably be picked up by the Discovery Channel, because they ain't never seen such thing as Big Head. They seen Bigfoot get killed. They ain't seen Big Head get destroyed. So it'll probably be picked up by the Discovery Channel.
I don't know about you guys, but I could watch these two guys go at it all day, every day. So make sure you tune in April 3rd as these two boxing legends take the ring together to face off. In Los Angeles, I'm Elise Ekback, reporting.